fraud, possible embezzlement, and potential criminal charges.
All of this comes after the New Mexico Finance Authority allegedly orchestrated a fake 2011 audit. New at 6, more concerns emerge after a board meeting to discuss the investigation. Action 7 News reporter Regina Reese was at the meeting and has the details.
A massive misstep to sort out and options for the next steps, including who will investigate the origin of the fake audit sent to investors and creditors.
The public's perception that you are now establishing a confidential attorney-client relationship with the agency that posted an admittedly bogus audit.
Newly appointed Financial Authority Board Chair Nan Winters raised serious concerns regarding approving the $1.275 million contract to law firm Steptoe & Johnson to review the alleged fraud.
I am struggling with how the point of contact and how this investigation is being supervised and managed by the agency that's being investigated, perhaps by the very perpetrators of the problem.
Along with the law firm's review, the state auditor's office is investigating the fraudulent audit and will report any criminal violations to law enforcement agencies.
The fake audit came to light last week. The Finance Authority Board says the former controller, Greg Campbell, is to blame for the fraud.
The Finance Authority issues billions of dollars in bonds and provides low-cost financing to New Mexico governments for capital improvement projects like the Rail Runner. Now that money could be put on hold. Reporting in Santa Fe, Regina Ruiz, Action 7 News.
The accounting firm cited for doing the 2011 audit says it didn't do the